Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your Excellency, the First Lady, Excellency, the Co-Chair, Minister Atmar, and Minister Spanningzai, Minister Nadri, distinguished panelists, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure to be here and talk about the inclusiveness in the peace negotiation process. Studies have shown that the degree of inclusivity in peace process is directly correlated with the sustainability of process. For instance, we have evidence that the inclusion of women in negotiation process is associated with more sustainable outcomes of political settlement. So, the importance of inclusivity in the process cannot be overstated. In the Republic negotiation team, we hold ourselves responsible and accountable to the whole of our society. If everyone cannot participate in negotiations in the room, it doesn't mean their absence, it doesn't mean exclusion from the process. It is for this reason that the members of the negotiation team regularly engage with the people from all walks of life, society, victims, especially victims of war, minority from across the country. We hear their views, expectations, demand, concern, and fears. On our end, we answer their questions, report on our activities, and explain the mechanics of the process. In this regard, we have to comment the role of our Ministry of Peace. It is the colleagues of the Ministry that make it possible for us to virtually connect with a large and diverse group of our fellow Afghans from all across the country. Additionally, we regularly consult with our international partner and member of support group. Our international partners provide us with technical support to help the ongoing negotiations process. An important aspect of our engagement with the international partners is working on the question of inclusivity. In the Republic negotiation team, we have shunned the idea that the only role of women in the peace process is to address women rights issues. Women in Afghanistan make up half of the population. We have every right to participate in decision-making on all topics. Within the team, women members have been assigned to different working committees. All these committees are responsible for working on topics that are of national relevance. As such, not only do we strongly defend women's rights alongside our male colleagues, but we actively make our voice heard in discussions that are meant to carve out the fate and future of peaceful, independent, and prosperous Afghanistan. We are grateful to our international partners for their steadfast support to Afghanistan over the two decades. Continued support of the international community is not only crucial for the ongoing negotiation process, but also in the year ahead. If and when a process leads to a peace agreement. A peace agreement will only be the beginning of another long and complex process of the peace building. In that, Afghanistan counts on the support of its international partners. We ask you to echo our calls for a ceasefire and do everything you can to make this a reality for the Afghan people. We ask for your right message within the process at the right time. Finally, we ask for your support in helping us protect and preserve those universally accepted values that we all believe in. Thank you very much.